crowns before the Lamb of God and sing, you're worthy of it all.
Pepper. Salt. Garlic powder. Adobo seasoning or seasoned salt. Mix it up and cover it. Okay, you guys, so at this point, all I did was pretty much pull the chicken apart. So me and my daughter wasn't feeling well, so this chicken soup really helped us, you guys. But this is just my way of making chicken soup. Hopefully this is approved by the lady that actually asked me to make chicken soup. I just put my twist on it. Okay, enjoy. Okay, so now that I pulled my chicken off of all of the pieces of meat, all of the bones, I have my bones right here. I'm not going to throw them away because they're actually good to make broth. Take all of that good seasoning. Remember that I showed you guys? Take it. Go around the pot. Y'all, my husband. Look at my husband. He's behind there eating. Y'all, he asked for a piece of chicken because he tasted it. So it is good. And that's just the chicken. So go ahead and dump your juice in there. I'm going to wash my pot out so then I can do my veggies. Actually, I'm not going to clean it. I use one of the good spatula things right here to get my edges. Keep that in there. Let's add some oil. Go ahead and cut up your veggies. Let's cook them down a little bit. Okay, so right here so far, I just have my bell peppers and my onions, and I'm mixing that up. I'm about to add my celery and my carrot and a little bit more green peppers. Okay, so now I'm going to, now that my onions are translucent, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to add my celery and my carrots. Y'all got celery rolling around. Right there. Mix it up. I'm going to go ahead and add the rest and then I'll be right back. Okay, now I'm going to add a can of chicken broth. Even though I already had chicken broth in here, I'm going to go ahead and add this whole can of chicken broth. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to put my meat back in. So go ahead, that full can of chicken broth. Mix it up. Now let me add my meat. Remember this meat right here and that juice. Go ahead and add all of that because that has that good old seasoning in there. And stir it up. And I'm gonna make my noodles. Okay, so I have my water on. I'm going to go ahead and add some olive oil to that for my egg noodles. And I'm going to also add a nice amount of salt, just like that. And I'm gonna let my water boil before I add some egg noodles. Cover it up. Add some fresh ginger. I'm gonna add a third cup of butter. I'm going to add some white cooking wine. Now this is really good for colds as well as the ginger because it's extremely strong. Noodles. Now I'm going to add some sweet corn with the juice and all. Okay, now my noodles are done. I did everything I needed to do. I'm going to turn that back on. They are rinsed and put back. So, okay, now I actually just move my soup in here with my noodles. You just want to mix it up, and that's pretty much it, you guys. All you want to look for is for your carrots to be soft enough, and it's done. You can see the chunks of meat, so on and so forth. Now, when I was younger, I remember my mom or my grandma, whenever they made it, especially my mom, she never really took the bones off. She would leave the bones in it, especially when my stepdad did it. He would leave the bones on the chicken, and you would just have to pluck through, y'all. It got my mouth watering. It smells so good. Okay, so this is pretty much it. If you want to make yours a little more creamier or thicken up the sauce, you can. That's up to you. That's your preference. But this is pretty much it for us, and I think it looks pretty good. Here it is right here. I added some saltine crackers and I added just a little bit of the stock, but not a lot.